The technique itself, of course, you know, it can cover so many different elements, because you know, the teachings, of course, they come from different parts of my training, like, you know, from the contemplative sense and the traditional sense. I still believe that, you know, I'm still a student. You know, I still learn from having to watch. I learn a lot from watching. I mean, that's what how I grew up. I mean, traditionally, you know, they say to you, sit, watch, listen, and do. So that's how I learn, you know. And then, of course, you know, you looking at the traditional dancers. I mean, especially the shamans, when they're doing things, you know, they don't teach you step and step. You look. And then after that, you know, you play the music or the instruments. Then there will be kind of like a fun 1 hour for the young people to be dancing by themselves, and of course they'll be drumming. So you kind of like copycat what you saw, so that you can embody that, you know, what you saw, and then you can be able to grow from that. So of course, you know, there's always a room to capture something from different parts of the world and cultures. So it's not only just one way. My basic training is Graham, and painful enough, you know, but it was Graham. I studied, of course, Mofeir Dalimon technique as well, and then I studied Balinese dance, and I studied Tai Chi. So all of those things, you know, they kind of like accumulate into what I do today. You know, there is no one way to learn. There are so many different ways to learn. So having to get this information, you know, from different mentors, either in South Africa where I was born, or in Australia or in Japan, it doesn't matter, you know, as long as, you know, the teachings are meant to make the body matured and grow, you know, personally and as an artist. Everybody has got a different way of expressing and a different way of doing things. And to allow them that freedom or the space to explore that in within the aspect of what the teacher has given them, they can grow out from there. Because, I mean, I use the positions, like, you know, the pot de bras in the same positions, but at the same time, it's a pot de bras, but in its extension, you know, which is the energy of the Tai Chi, like, you know, of course, it's all cycle, you know, it's all cycles, and then it's the pot de bras, okay, I'm extending, and then it's everything, it's all linked, you know, and then at the same time, at the bottom, something is happening. It's about, you know, really collecting this force, you know. Of course, you see that the people are bouncing and bouncing and bouncing and bouncing, and you're thinking, my goodness, people are killing themselves. You know, what's happening there? You know, to train the body, to give it a freedom to breathe in a different way, rather than to hold everything inside the body and without having to generate that energy inside it. Because most of the people, including some of my dancers where I come from in France, they work too much exterior. There's too much tension from outside, and then nothing after that happens, you know, and then everything becomes just the peripheral.
It doesn't mean that you have to fight with your legs. You have to breathe.
The important thing is that, you know, once a dancer is able to retain that energy, that spirit inside themselves, even though they may not know that they've got a spirit which is hidden underneath, and to find it is very, very difficult. It's something that, you know, they will notice in their change of the body, in how they interpret the movement and how they express themselves during the process. You know, Koba, initially where it comes from, it comes from my grandmother. I watch my grandmother, she'll be swiping the yard. How come, you know, you swipe for an hour, hour and a half, then you come up like as if nothing was happening? And then when I go to Japan, I see the older women and the older men picking up rice in a heat sun, wearing their head. I watch them for 3 hours, and then they stand up and they're fine. And then you're kind of thinking, exactly how can they do this? And my grandma, she said to me, well, you know, you have to eat the soil. Meaning, and for me, you know, I took it so literal that, you know, she must be insane. She said, I must eat the soil. But actually, no. You know, meaning that, you know, you have to eat the energy of the earth, which is what we call that, the force of nature. because the traditional dancer, they can dance for hours before they can go into trance. So that is a preparation, you know, and then having to eat the soil, the mother nature, the force of nature, you know, it prepares you to be able to go somewhere else, you know, within that, you know, you are here, but you are not here at the same time. So, you know, to be able to get Koba is of course, it's hard, but at the same time, it should not be hard, because if you use the correct information that, you know, a teacher is able to give you, if you are listening and being patient about it, that, you know, okay, when is this finishing? Because we go forever, you know, we go forever. When is this finishing? When is this finishing? Don't worry about that. Worry about how you can generate that energy inside the body. You know, it's how to create that energy so that, you know, you feel completely lost in space, and then you just feel like you are swimming in a pool of whatever it is that, you know, you feel inside yourself, and that you won't even feel any pain. You'll just, it will be just you there and your moment and the space. You know, it's just magic already, and it's something that, you know, I try to implement, you know, I hope to implement while I'm here at Bates.